Hello everyone, my name is Srishti Jayant Deshmukh. This video clip is going to be about the online resources that you can use for the preparation of civil service examination. Now, I'm compiling these websites specially and in a different manner because I feel that internet has played a huge role in adding value to my notes and the entire knowledge for CSE. So I hope that it adds value to your preparation as well and you gain from it.
So here are the different categories which will be covered in this video and related to the UPSC preparation specifically, or current affairs or general studies paper, whatever websites I have found useful, I will be mentioning it here in this clip. So the first is about current affairs, which is purely about the day-to-day happenings and will tell you and will update you about the news. The Press Information Bureau, or the PIB, is a website which will allow you to get an update of what all is happening, who is coming, who's going, then what all government schemes are being launched, their performances. Everything is very nicely analyzed here, and you'll get, if you subscribe to the feed of all ministries, you'll get it on your ID, and then you can choose depending upon the syllabus of UPSC as well as the previous year paper question trends, so you can decide as for which and what all is important and not. So the next website is about the news on AIR. This has all the programs that are aired on the national radio. I especially listen to the program News Analysis, which is a 14-minute program but has a good understanding about issues, and you can hear it in Hindi as well. The next website is DK Today. Here I used to solve the daily quiz which was there. Daily about 10 questions are posted, and they are related to current affairs, so it's a good revision as well. The Rajya Sabha TV YouTube channel is a wonderful source for covering your current affairs. Especially I used to listen to the Big Picture and India's World, which deepens our understanding of issues, and the debates really help us. Now we will move on to the websites which are completely oriented towards UPSC preparation. So there are three websites that have played a huge role in my entire preparation, and I have grown as an aspirant towards being a person who is able to write good answers with a good knowledge base only because of support of these websites, I will say. The first is Insights on India. Now, the best initiative that I felt of this is the Secure initiative, where they actually give you questions daily, and they also give the reference articles. So I used to read those articles first and then wrote my own answers, and then I uploaded it on the Discuss platform. So I reviewed other people's answers and other students reviewed mine. So that was a good learning that came from this end. And apart from it, there are daily current affairs, and there is quiz, there are editorials, there is topper strategy. So all of these things you can refer to from this website. It is really helpful. I also refer to the last 6 or 7 tests for the prelims examination from this website, and I found them really helpful. The next website is IAS Baba. Now this also has helped me really well. The TLP program of IAS Baba is very good. And they post questions, they categorize the syllabus first of all, and according to that they post questions. Even the essay questions or essay topics are mentioned, and you are supposed to write answers. For prelims, there's a 60-day program kind of a thing which they run. So when I was giving my prelims, I also referred to that as well. And I subscribed to the All India Prelims Test Series of IAS Baba as well. So and there's an interview program which was there, which they used to where they used to post the questions for the interview. So many such initiatives, I benefited from it. The third website which I'd like to mention is the Forum IAS blog. Now the two things that I was really regular following on this was, first was the 9 PM brief, where the entire news of the entire day, they just provide the gist of it, and I used to revise it every single day. And the second initiative that I also religiously followed was the 10 PM quiz, So they post about 6 to 7 questions or 5 to 6 questions. You can solve those MCQs. And apart from that, there are motivational articles, somebody under the name Neon writes it. So these articles, when you read it, you feel on track with the exam, with everybody else. So you could just take help from all of these websites. They will help you out to keep a track of your preparation. And even if you are away, they won't let you feel that you are out of the race. So, you know, these websites, keep connected to them. Keep yourself connected to them. The site exam.in is a very different kind of a website. So they will keep you posted about some important happenings, some news, and some digital versions of books are also made available here. Find some tests that are available in Delhi. So the rare resources could be found out here on exam.in. Moving on to General Studies Paper 1. Now there's not much which can be covered in this paper from the website because it is much of it is the static part. But still, in geography, I always felt that if I could get quality notes, it'll be good. So there's this website called the Poor Man Friends IS website, PMF. Here they provide very good notes. So I refer to these notes for geography portion, and you can use it to refer, or you can just see the selected topics from here. And the environment section also has been covered in great detail and nicely in an understandable manner. So you can refer it here. Another two YouTube channels which can be really helpful for geography are, the first one is Rajdhanil Ma'am's lecture under Mrunal, which you can find in YouTube. There she has covered the chapters on climatology and resources section very well. So I did those chapters from there. And secondly, if you are getting bored reading the NCERTs, you can just open the Amit Sen Gupta Sir's channel on YouTube. There he covers the NCERTs of geography, and he explains it very well. So I used these two lectures, these two channels to actually enhance my understanding of geography. Now, Economic and Political Weekly is one such source which can be useful for covering the society section. Sociology students can enhance their understanding of some specific topics, or in general for paper 1 in GS1 for the society section, you can study the articles in EPW, and it can also help you in general studies paper 2 somewhere as well because of the polity section. So very good articles are published here, and it is authentic as well, so you can refer to it here. Moving on to the category on general studies paper 2, here I will be telling you the different website which can help you out in adding value to your texts which you read for paper 2. The first website is Vikaspedia.in. Now this is a government owned website, so it is really authentic, the information given here, and they provide you government schemes and the objectives of different schemes. So instead of moving through the websites of ministries, you can directly go to Vikaspedia and study the aims, objectives, and other such information related to any grant or any scheme of any ministry. And they provide it in one place, and it is really helpful to cover issues of hunger, education, other such places where you want to quote the different schemes and want to learn it. So you can find it here. Now this website, the PRS Legislative Research, can be really helpful in covering the polity part of General Studies 2. Here you can find the summary of different bills that are laid in the parliament, some of the objectives. They also provide their own comments on it, how it is helpful, what are the negatives. You can find it there. And they also compile different committees' reports. So any committee which is found, formed, their report is summarized there. You can read it from there. And any such source related to polity or law can be nicely referenced from here. Moving on to the international relations part, which is very much dynamic. So I did not refer to any per se book for international relation. I just relied on the newspapers that we read, and apart from that, I also studied articles from these two websites. The first is the IDSA website, the Institute of Defense Studies and Analysis. Now here they provide a very good analysis of any international event or anything that's happening on the international platform. The views are balanced, and you can just refer for some technical terms which can be used in our answers are also used here. So you can go through the articles. Now, this website of Observer Research Foundation, which is an Indian think tank, is really helpful. They provide you with articles related to economy or international relation or education or hunger, any such major important event or issue of the country. They provide it there. There are articles on technology as well, so you can just go through it, and some of these articles and viewpoints add value to your answers. So keep reading the views, and for international relation you can also go through the website of Ministry of External Affairs. There they have compiled the different how the relations are with different countries, so that can complete your search. Moving on to General Studies paper 3, you will find that this paper is very dynamic, and the different topics that are mentioned in the syllabus, if you cover it very properly, the preparation of GS3 is also very much organized and will become easy. So try and pay attention on the different topics, categorize them pretty well. There are some websites that can help you. The first I'll say is Livement. Now, this website has good articles related to economy, and you can either subscribe or you can just go through the website every now and then. So these articles are provide you very good information and some good arguments which can be used in your answers. For referring to specific terms which are there in economy, the website Arthopedia can be very helpful. It is maintained by Indian Economic Service officers, and it can be really helpful to clear your concepts. They keep updating some new key terms like the HAM, the hybrid annuity model, or any such infrastructure model. I saw the definitions there and it was really nicely given. You can refer to this website for core concepts of economy. Now, this website of the World Economic Forum, I am referring it here because every week, if you subscribe to it, they post you some articles which are of the issues that are important at a global level. So there are issues on unemployment, on industrial revolution related to technology, economy, education, a lot of subjects are covered. So this website is really helpful even for covering the science and tech portion. There the portions of biotechnology or artificial intelligence, etc., it's given very nicely. So there are also mind maps are also given on this. You can refer to this website and it will help you to learn a lot. Finally, this website of the United Nations Environment Program will help you to keep updated about the issues in environment at a global level, and for covering the environment section for the different days like the Earth Day and Water Day, whatever keeps coming on, they have good articles and quality content can be taken from here. This can be a fodder for your essay or your answers or your understanding in general. So keep going through the website time and again. Finally, moving on to General Studies paper 4. Now, this is an area which we feel that we rarely can read from any website or internet. But there are two websites which I would still like to refer here that have helped me somehow in my preparation. The first is the website Skills You Need. Now, this is a very unique website. In a very simple, easy to understand language, they convey to you concepts of honesty, discipline, leadership, working in a team, coordination, then discipline, integrity, or topics related to stress management, anger management, emotional intelligence. It has been covered really well. So you can refer to this website for your understanding of these issues. Another website which I would like to share here is the website of OECD. Now, this website has very good authentic documents related to public integrity, corruption, etc., and the terms and the way they write about it can directly be used in your answers. Especially there's a document on public integrity. I thought that the concepts of corruption and related to that were covered so well in it. So you can just glance through the website and see what adds value to your preparation of ethics and integrity. Finally, after covering all the papers, I will say the Niti Aayog's website is one baseline website which can help you to add so much to your preparation. A lot of it is given there. For example, please do read the document or the 3-year action agenda given by Niti Aayog. It will add so much fodder to your answers in paper 2 and paper 3 and essay as well. And especially, I'll also say there are different documents or public releases that they do with regard to any study which is conducted. For example, there are recent articles on electric vehicles or biotechnology or artificial intelligence. Please go through them, and I hope that they add value to your preparation entirely, and you are able to gain. There's also documents on the best practices of the entire country there. So those examples can be quoted in your answers very nicely, and they can, I probably feel, can fetch us more marks. At the end, I will also mention that the resources that I've told you here is only and only because I myself have referred to them. So choose what suits you the best, because all the needs of our guidance, the needs of all our guidance are different. Choose what suits you. All the very best to you. Finally, I would say that you have to stay motivated throughout the entire journey. Follow the resources, whatever you get, and keep working hard.